So, in this microbuild, my daughter Nova has told me for her birthday she wants Harley Quinn's mallet. Now, I don't quite approve because she was inspired by the movie version. She hasn't even seen Suicide Squad, but she likes the look of it and stuff, which I don't, you know, it's a shame that it wasn't inspired by her, you know, the real Harley Quinn from the 90s ones, but, you know, whatever. So, I got this piece of awesome ship's mast. This is a chunk of ship's mast that was very kindly donated to me by Gannon and Benjamin, which are a local shipyard here on the vineyard. I found it in their scrap pile, and they didn't seem to mind me taking it for my nefarious purposes. So, I've already marked from all of the pictures I could find of the mallet, it was, I couldn't get the size of it, but it was roughly 1.25, whatever the diameter was, the length was then 1.25 of that. So we're cutting it here. And this is a mast, so it was further complicated by the fact that the there's this end of it is 8 millimeters less than this end of it. So there's roughly a 3.5 millimeter difference between the diameter of one of the mallet faces than the other. Cue the YouTube comments about me using the saw wrong. I don't work with wood. Wood's not my thing. Do I have a bigger one? There we go. That's the stuff. Badly off the line. I wasn't so badly off the line going around. Ordinarily I'd be worried with the chips along the edge, but the real one, actually there is a prop, so I guess it's not finger time to say the real one is all battered and chipped along the edge. Also, the real one looks like it's made out of something white. Like, it looks white too. So, the fact that this is painted some kind of cream color, I might just leave it or sand it lightly. So now, I think in a lot of depictions, it's just as a normal straight handle. This is a shovel handle I bought new because I had a look around here and I didn't quite trust any of the stuff I could find around here to hold up to the abuse. What length to make this guy? A lot of its handle, I'm sure the prop one has a definite length, but this is actually bigger than the prop one, if unless Margot Robbie has giant monster hands. So think about there. Also, we're making this for a 10-year-old, so this is my sneaky way of making it more like the one from the cartoon, which I view as the real one. I mean, the look of it, it'll look different. See, the one from the cartoon actually looks cartoony, like it's just a big brown, it's just a, like it wasn't interesting looking, this was just brown and this was just brown. And it didn't have much of a design to it. Whereas the movie one, even though the movie was terrible, the movie one at least had a little bit of interesting, little few interesting features, like the paint going, or the painted design on it and stuff. So we'll chop it off there, and now we have to find a spade bit. Spade? Is that, that's what you call the type of one for drilling the fake metal. But now But I'll burn you. Reset. Burp. Burp. Come on. What do we got? 1.43. 1.43? That's not a nice number. So, in the world of crazy things working out every so often, I found this in my scrap pile. I have no idea why I have this massive drill bit. I have no idea why it happens to be the 1 7/16 or whatever it was. It actually measures a little bit bigger. But we have to do the test now because I got a piece of wood and I drilled a sample hole. And now it's just to see, will this guy go in? If it goes in, it goes in! Ah! But it's a tiny bit baggy. How baggy is it? It's not. Man, it's so close. It's like if you were trying to drill for clearance. I could put it in like that and then use plates to lock it into position. How wobbly would it be? God, even a piece of paper. Well, the chance of me, I couldn't find a spade bit that was the right size, so I think we're going to go for this one. It's slightly bigger than 1 7/16. So I wonder what this guy was supposed to be. Switch it to millimeters and see, is this some like bizarre, does it measure a flat number of millimeters? Kinda. A 37 millimeter drill bit. I mean, I don't know. I sharpened the front of it. It was all rusty when I found it. And I cleaned up the shank on the back, which luckily is the same type of shank as my drill. But yeah, no idea why I have this. So, because the 4 millimeter difference between this side and this side, this side is propped up by 2 millimeters here. I'm trying to get the center mark. Also, these marks will help me identify whether the lump is standing upright in the thing. Now,
can you turn me in love with Dad?
You want to watch Ant-Man?
Yeah.
Okay.
Can you come? We have to turn it off at 7:30.
Okay, hang on, Christopher. And so I have a straight line here, a straight line here, and in the middle of that is where, oh, where's it gone? Here. What's this straight line? Oh, that's when I was cutting it. We drill somewhere in here. To push it with this guy at the start because there's a kind of a scoop here that I was trying to disguise this mostly by drilling the hole here. Then when this gets widened out, then there's like a black thing as a support, so I was trying to get rid of this bar shape, but it meant drilling into that where I wanted it to drill to actually land. This is a, I think it's called an airplane bit. It's a very low drill bit, but I didn't feel a satisfying like the two things lined up, so we're gonna raise the table a bit and see. Indeed, is there given any indication at all? I think it's lined up, it's going off easy.
my lagoon that is in there. But you know, actually I wouldn't be able to do this, so they must be lined up.
What? I blew into the hole. Why did it come back at me? But anyway, I can see through.
Hang on, how do I do this? Whoop.
Okay, here we go. Yeah, I turned the speed down, but loses torque at the lower speeds. This seems too fast to me. Widened out the pilot hole to half inch.
Hang on, just gonna check.
Still in the middle. Lots of work. I think that's the deepest, biggest hole I've ever drilled in anything. Why is that go? Okay. These are the offcuts from making the pommel of the the Sunkeeper. Where are my gloves so I don't get another wound? But because of the shape of the offcut, you can make a wedge like you have on the top of an axe. This kind of a little... Does that make sense? Is the camera focusing? Now, the handy dandy YouTube video I found detailing putting the, you know, just how to put an axe handle on, said it doesn't so much matter if this stuff in here cracks when I'm doing this, but that seems doubtful and I'd prefer if it didn't, so. Oh man, that's already cracked.
and it's off to one side. Garbage. All right. There we go. Hopefully that will stay put enough for a 10-year-old. Whoop. Come on, come on. Children's birthday present. Oh, don't slip out of the thing. Makes my job hard. It's only £6. Is that right? 6.5. It's one of the lightest things I've ever met. I've met knives heavier than that. So what I'm doing here is I'm trying to get a template for the face of the mallet. I know if I freehand it, it'll wind up all wonky looking and I won't be happy. So this might be unnecessary, but here's what we're doing. I'm drawing a circle because I want to stretch the image I found on the interwebs to fit into a circle and then print it out. And then I won't be thinking that I drew the face weird. So what we're going to do is, I think plan A was we were going to then drag two more guides in, and because the shape on the internet image is an oval, we can do a copy, just select an ellipse-shaped area. But what happens is when you do that is you realize that the ellipse the squished circle is not squished 90 degrees to the 90 degrees to the plane that the image is on. So I created this black shape and then lowered the opacity to make sure that it was lined up properly. Do I do that now? Bloop. And then I'll go, yeah, that looks about right. And then took in some more guides to see where these are lining up with the middles of the center line through the transform. And then ruler tool, straighten layer, and that should recorrect the background image, or correct the background image. So now the ellipse is lined up, so that I should be able to just stretch it out and get something like a circle. I mean, it's not a perfect science because also the circle is, there's some distortion because of it receding backwards. But it's close enough for a thing that I was initially just going to totally freehand. That's me trying to straighten it up. Yet again, that's not really necessary. It's easier to tell if it's totally wonky looking. See, because of the way it's drawn, it's hard to tell. Is the right-hand side of the smile bigger because it was, because of perspective or because of the way it was actually drawn? So now we adjust the size. It's 156 mils tall. We want it to be 160, so that's 102% roughly. And once we adjust it to 102%, which should make it actually the 160 millimeters across, now we can print it and have a life size measure, 161, close enough for our purposes. And we can print it out and use that as a template just to make sure that the face on the mallet is somewhat correct. Make sure it's at 100% and print. I don't know what picture it was I was looking at before, but it turns out this guy, I went inside the house to do some prep for, get some prep references pictures for painting it. And it turns out this guy is flat. I'm going to wait till that dries. Oh, it's stinky in here. I'm going to wait till that dries. I have everything I need except the blue for the handle. I found some black and I found some red. Well, I said those in the reverse order, but you get the idea. And I have a blue and red permanent marker, which is a little bit cheap, but I think would actually do well for doing the writing around the edges.
And that's it. I'm gonna wait till that dries before I start messing with the doing the border. Oh, I got the measurements, not the measurements, the proportions slightly wrong. I was looking at the one in the movie again, and Margot Robbie is probably smaller than me, although I might be wrong. And if so, this hammer is actually bigger, but I think that's more of my subconscious desire to make the cartoon one instead, creeping through. But the proportions, I have to reduce this. I change it so this dimension here was the same as my dimension across, 160. But the dimension lengthways then, when you did that, I was 6 millimeters out, so it's not 1 1/4 exactly. It's this one was the real one, the one from the film was actually stubbier. Which I think would look worse, but which is probably why I didn't do it that way. My brain would not have allowed it. Got the diamonds masked off. And originally I was going to do the writing afterwards, but I just realized it would be handier and it would be done if I did it now before I had to wait 6 hours for paint to dry. Originally I wasn't going to bother with the writing at all because I was afraid it was going to say some relatively creepy stuff, and I didn't want to put that on my daughter's 180 degrees turn, killing you, ha ha ha. The killing you is in red. Killing you is in blue. That's in red. But I looked at it and it's not creepy. Like, I thought it was going to be that, you know, that horrible, like, daddy's little monster. Also, the writing is in weird foo-foo cursive, which I am more of my natural writing style is more of a dadly all caps. Anyway, I'll get back to you when I have it done. Filmed it before I put the tape over, but that's everything masked off now and ready to paint. The diamonds get painted red, the strip gets painted black. What's the rule with masking tape? Are you supposed to take it off while the paint's still wet? Or do you leave it while it's doing its thing? I do not know. Oh! That line is blurrier than I would have liked, but I guess that's the, when you're dealing with wood. It was blurry on the original one too. And I thought I was going to get a better result than the actual prop, but it's about the same. Like, if this was metal, I'd be super unhappy. That's a blurry, blurry line. Anyway, I'm going to go around and take off this stuff in case there is a weirdness about taking it off once it's dry. Like the edge flaking or any garbage like that. That's not too bad, I suppose. Is that an airplane wrecking my sound? It is an airplane wrecking my sound. But now we just have to wait the 16 hours or whatever the hell it takes for oil paint to dry. Oh, and the handle. I'm thinking instead of paint, because I know that the paint will come off using blue duct tape. They have quality duct tapes at the local hardware store for doing costume stuff. I often make Halloween stuff for the kids for like a one shot out of the colored duct tape, and it still hangs around. So I think I'm gonna go with blue duct tape for the handle, and it's got a black bit on the end and a black bit up by the handle. But that's the head done. Paint thinner covered rag. Oh wow, that's so anti-climatic. Hang on.
Sorry, guys. I thought this would go up like it would just explode, but... I mean, that's something. Painters, it's no gasoline, that's for sure.
Be awkward on me. Oh, it's because it's not going in. It's not going in straight to the handle. The where it meets the handle is, of course, a funny shape because it's going disappearing into a curved surface. So that's why this guy is being a little bit fussy on me. Gorilla tape. Now. But you can see the blue duct tape and the black. I just think it has a higher chance of surviving than if I'd painted these. So, that's the mallet finished. Nova, do you want to try and pick her up? Do you like your mallet?
Yes.
Do you want to go try and smash some stuff?
Yes!
So one of the first things we're going to try and smash, these guys, Dogmite? Am I saying that right? I think this is the first time I've said it out loud. And it just seems like an odd phrase. Dogmite, there it is. They sent me a fancy dice box. And they said, here's a fancy dice box for you, Mike. And by way of, here's a not so fancy dice box we made. And it would be great if you could smash that in your video. And it just so happens that this one is more or less the same as the Harley Quinn colors. Hey Nova, do you think you can smash this?
Yeah.
Okay, let's see, is that actually true? No, not in here, we're gonna do it outside. Get back, should I say go?
Wait, we're lighting it on fire?
We're lighting everything on fire.
I'm nervous. That's the fire part.
Yeah, it'll be fine. How are you going to hold the hammer? Show me how you're going. Okay, as much force as you can.
Okay.
Hit it! So Nova, do you like your mallet?
Yes!
Are you gonna
cleaning off after smashing all that stuff though?
Are you gonna bring it to school?
Yes!
What are you gonna do with it at school?
Smash the school. I hate homework. Smash!
I'm gonna try it one time.
No, Mom.
Yes, Nova.
One time if you don't smash it.
Come on.
Okay. Ready?
Mom!
Yay! There we go.
There's still a huge chunk for me to smash!
Okay.
Oops. I might smash.
Okay.
I might put that in at the end. Keep going.